We have enjoyed a beautiful Sydney day, blue skies and sunshine with light to moderate northeasterly winds. Temperatures up to 2 degrees warmer than average, reaching 25 in Terrey Hills, 27 in most suburbs, including Kellyville, Liverpool, Campbelltown and the city, a warmer 28 degrees in Penrith. A few showers across the northern rivers today, Byron Bay picking up 4 millimetres, the rest of the state staying dry. Temperatures reaching the mid-20s along the coast, but staying stubbornly hot across inland areas. The latest climate update from the Bureau of Meteorology has shown El Niño is persisting, but it is starting to weaken and likely to return to neutral by the end of April. New South Wales is expecting conditions to be hotter and drier than average over the next 3 months. Let's take a look at tomorrow, and showers and storms will scatter across WA's east and the tropics, a high dominating the southeast. Take a look around the country tomorrow. Brisbane will be fine, 29 degrees, partly cloudy, and 31 in Canberra. Fine and 27 in Melbourne, hot and sunny in Adelaide and in Perth, heading for 33 degrees. No rain is expected around New South Wales tomorrow, and the coast will be several degrees warmer than today, reaching 30 in Grafton, 31 in Newcastle, Batemans Bay and Bega, staying warm across inland areas too, 35 in Narrabri, Wagga Wagga and Albury. And there is a hazardous surf warning for the Byron, Coffs and Macquarie coasts, with strong winds further south around Batemans Bay. After possible fog in the west, Sydney will be dry and mostly sunny tomorrow with light to moderate northeasterly winds, heading for a top of 27 in Cronulla, 29 on the way for the city, while our western suburbs will all see tops in the low 30s. Penrith, once again, one of our warmest suburbs, heading for a top of 33 degrees. Let's take a look ahead, and Thursday will be partly cloudy with a possible late shower, heading for 27. That shower could last into early Friday morning before clearing to a partly cloudy day with a top of 28. The weekend looking picture perfect, sunny and 29 degrees. Those blue skies continuing into next week with overnight lows ranging from 18 to 20 degrees. In our west, we could see a late storm on Thursday. That could bring up to 2 millimetres of rain, and it will come after a very hot and humid day, heading for a top of 30 degrees. And then we'll see a possible light shower early on Friday, 29, before clearing to partly cloudy skies. Mostly sunny across the weekend and on Monday with tops of 30 to 31. Reaching 34 by this time next week. Tonight will be the coolest night of the next week, dipping to 16. Tomorrow night will be 4 degrees warmer, Pete.
Hello again. The city was back in the 30s today. After a low of 12 degrees, it reached 32. It warmed up into the 30s almost right across Melbourne, and that was despite most suburbs dipping to single figures overnight. That was also the case for Geelong. It fell to 9 degrees and went on to reach 32 this afternoon. It was a chilly night across most of the state, down to 7 at Ballarat and also Orbost. But once the sunshine got to work, northern and western districts climbed into the low to mid-30s. Most of Gippsland peaked in the high 20s, but Warragul made it to 31. There's widespread storms and showers through WA at the moment, but it's staying dry in the southwest corner, so Perth enjoyed a sunny top of 32. A high that's sitting over the Tasman has been directing northerly breezes across Victoria today, and they'll continue tomorrow until a weak trough travels over Bass Strait and sends in some southerlies. So Thursday will be our coolest day of the week, and there could even be some drizzly showers during the morning, but they'll clear for a mild and pleasant autumn day. It'll be a warm day for all our capital cities tomorrow. Perth and Adelaide both heading for 33, 29 for Brisbane and Sydney, 31 in Canberra, and Hobart is expected to climb 6 degrees above its March average with a forecast top of 26. Back home, it'll be a warmer night statewide. Then once again, maximums will be well above the March average. Most of the state is heading for the low to mid-30s, but the cool change will arrive in the southwest of the state first. So a little cooler there, 23 degrees at Warrnambool, 28 at Hamilton. A few isolated showers could pop up over western districts ahead of the change, but nothing more than a sprinkle. Melbourne is also in for a warmer night, with most spots set to dip to 15 or 16 degrees. Cooler in Ferny Creek, 12, and Moorabbin is only expected to dip to 17. Then under partly cloudy skies, northern suburbs are expected to reach 29 degrees, up to 31 at Coldstream, 27 and 28 for most other spots, 25 degrees at Ferny Creek and Rosebud, and cooler southerlies are expected to move in just before lunchtime. For Geelong, a low of 14, then a partly cloudy top of 27. The city is only expected to dip to 17, then it's also forecast to reach 27. A drizzly start to Thursday, then a cooler day, 23 degrees, but it'll be mild and partly cloudy. Then it'll start to warm up again. 27 on Friday to start the long weekend. An 11 degree jump will send the city to a scorching 38 degrees on Saturday. The hottest day in summer only got to 37. The northerly winds will be a little gusty at times, so there'll be elevated fire danger in parts of the state. It'll stay warm on Sunday and Monday with maximums of 32, back to 25 next Tuesday. But we've got another warm and dry autumn day ahead of us tomorrow. After an overnight low of 17, the city is expected to reach 27 under partly cloudy skies. A sweltering start to the long weekend.
Well, Melissa, thankfully much lighter falls today, most of it this morning and sort of clearing up by the afternoon. Unlike the heavy falls we still had last night with those persistent thunderstorms up around the Sunshine Coast hinterland, there were quite a few rain gauges that recorded more than 200 millimetres. Today, though, much lighter, as I mentioned. If we have a look at the radar, starting from early this morning, 10 millimetres in the rain gauges around Samford, Caboolture, Alimba. They were probably the heaviest falls on the north side today, much lighter on the southern side of Brizzy. It is clear now in the city. Let's have a look at temperatures today. As I mentioned earlier, slightly below average, one of those rarer days, courtesy of those gusty southeasterly winds. More than 60k they gusted to at Cape Morton, 72k at Double Island Point. Most of the suburbs made it into the high 20s, with Caboolture, Redcliffe and Gatton only reaching 26 today, Toowoomba topping out at 23 degrees. Now the weather map, widespread showers and storms over the tropics and down through WA and Western South Australia. Showers in eastern Queensland and New South Wales from onshore winds but easing. A cool southerly change making its way along the New South Wales coast. Interstate, we're looking at a mostly sunny day and warm conditions for Perth, Adelaide, Melbourne, Hobart, Sydney and Canberra. So looking fine in the south. It'll be hot for Alice Springs, showers and storms again for Darwin. Queensland expects showers and the chance of thunderstorms for the north coast, the lower Burdekin, central coast and Whitsundays. A possible shower and storm for the Capricornia. Partly cloudy and warm across the Wide Bay and Burnett. Looking hot inland and mostly sunny tomorrow. For the southeast, partly cloudy. There is the slight chance of a shower in the north again. East-southeasterly winds around 15 to 20k. Cooler overnight, Toowoomba dropping down to 16 degrees, while daytime temperatures, high 20s for the coast and bayside, up to 30 degrees inland. Moreton Bay, southeasters, 10 to 15 knots, so easing back from today, the seas up to a metre. Brisbane, partly cloudy, a low of 21 overnight and a top 29 degrees. Your 7-day outlook, well, partly cloudy Thursday, 29, a shower or two Friday, Saturday, Sunday and Monday, temperatures reaching 29 each day. Ipswich, Thursday 30 and partly cloudy, a possible shower Friday, Saturday, Sunday and Monday, not a lot in it. Temperatures will be in the low 30s each day. For the Gold Coast, a possible shower Thursday. A couple of showers though returning for Friday, over the weekend and early next week. We're looking at high 20s each day. For the Sunshine Coast, a shower or two on Thursday and Friday. Showers increasing for Saturday, Sunday and into Monday. Also expecting high 20s each day. It's nice to see those temperatures pushing back to the high 20s and a comfortable day today, but mostly fine tomorrow, guys.
Hello again. Well, something really nice has been happening in the city over the past hour or so. We've just had some really comforting cloud cover building up, starting to just soften up those skies a little bit and take a bit of sting out of that heat. It has been a warm day today. We got up to around 34 degrees, but right now it's softened back to around 29 degrees. I do have quite an uncomfortable forecast coming up for you, though. Of course, it is autumn now, but we are really going to be feeling like we're pretty much in the peak of summer over the next week or so. So I will take you through it. Now, across the suburbs today, we were pretty much in the 30s everywhere along the plains. In fact, we were in the mid-30s through the northern suburbs. We got up to 35 degrees at Mawson Lakes today and Norlunga hit 33, but it was softer in the hills. We had 29 degrees at Mount Lofty. In the north, we've got these outback rains that are continuing out through our north and west. So we had rain at Ernabella today. It's been hot too, with 40 degrees from Coober Pedy across to Ceduna. Through the south, well, we landed in the mid-30s around from Kadena across to Renmark, and it has been dry through the south as well. On the charts, we have a high-pressure system that's keeping us dry, but plenty going on around the country. It's looking very wet through the tropics down through Western Australia there, but dry along the east coast for now. So if you are travelling interstate tomorrow, Brisbane going for 29 degrees, and Sydney will probably come in around the same mark. Back in South Australia, and it's another hot one. We're back up to 40 degrees again tomorrow for Roxby Downs. Port Augusta will likely land around the 37 degree mark, but a big drop off along the coast. We've got Port Lincoln going for 26 degrees. And there is a lot of variation, in fact, when we compare those inland temperatures to the coastal temperatures. Take Renmark, for example, going for 37 degrees tomorrow versus Kingscote expecting just 27 degrees. So a 10 degree temperature difference there. Mount Gambier also expecting an easy at 27. Now take care on the water tomorrow around the Spencer Gulf. We have a marine wind warning in place there. And locally on metro waters, south to southwesterlies to 15 knots, tending south to southeasterly to 20 knots in the early afternoon. Around Adelaide tomorrow, it is another warm one. We have Elizabeth going for 34 degrees, Golden Grove 33 and Marion 32. In the city, we're going for 33 degrees. Again, it will be dry with an overnight low of around 19 degrees. But where that heat really kicks in is on the 7-day forecast. And it really is quite a prolonged stretch of autumn heat. So Friday, we're going for 36 degrees. On Saturday, across the long weekend, we are up to a very hot 39 degrees. On Sunday, going for 36 degrees, and Monday again, 36 degrees, and even staying above 30 degrees as we go through to the middle stages of next week. It also could be quite windy on Saturday, and particularly considering that we've gone now 38 days in a row in Adelaide with no rain recorded and no rain on the forecast. We factor in the wind and the heat on Saturday. That's certainly a day that fire authorities will be watching very closely. So far this season, we've been lucky in that we haven't had a lot of windy weather. So fire is probably on edge for that day. And I think it's fair to say, if you are heading out to perhaps Womadelaide or any of the festivals, that Mad March is off to a very hot start. Yeah.